We are delighted to have with us a friend of mine. She is Diane Gramley, who happens to be the president of the American Family Association of Pennsylvania. Diane, welcome once again to Stand in the Gap today.
Well, thanks for having me, Pastor Gary. I appreciate the opportunity to speak about this very important bill.
Well, yes, it's a very important bill, and we're going to be discussing this bill that I believe, if passed, will take great strides in reducing the number of abortions that take place in America. The bill we're talking about, ladies and gentlemen, is H.R. 490, referred to as the Heartbeat Protection Act of 2017. This bill was introduced and placed into the House Judiciary Committee on January the 12th, 2017, by Representative Steve King of Iowa, and has about 168 other sponsors representing 37 states of the Union. And Diane, to get started here, please tell our audience about H.R. 490 and why it is so significant to the pro-life movement in America. According to our understanding, this bill amends the federal criminal code to make it a crime for a physician to knowingly perform an abortion under certain circumstances. Is that correct,
yes,
Diane?
Correct. And I think the majority of Americans do not understand that it is perfectly legal in the majority of states in this union to perform an abortion on a perfectly viable baby up until the time of birth. That's basically what Roe v. Wade opened up in 1973. But what H.R. 490 does is it does make it a crime for a physician to knowingly perform an abortion. He has to determine whether the fetus has a detectable heartbeat. That's the first thing he has to do. And he must inform the mother of the results of detecting the heartbeat, whether there's one there or not. And then after determining that a fetus does have a detectable heartbeat, if he performs that abortion, after going through those three steps, if he performs that abortion, then he does face criminal charges.
Wow, Diane, that is a phenomenal, phenomenal thing. Do you know any of the folks that have signed on as co-sponsors of this bill? I know Representative Steve King, who has a solid, solid history of being pro-life, is the one that introduced the bill. But are there any other names that you can give to us so that our nationwide audience can understand if one of their representatives has signed on to sponsor this?
Well, I know that there are 37 co-sponsors, or rather 37 states represented in the bill itself as co-sponsors. We have 9 from Pennsylvania alone, pro-life individuals who've signed on. Of course, we have other ones right off the top of my head. I can't think of them. I'm sorry, but it's a significant number. Just the fact that we have 169 counting, Representative King, is just phenomenal that we have that many who are signing on. But I would almost guarantee you that the majority of those are Republicans, as you saw with the recently passed pain capable bill. There were only 3 Democrats who joined the majority of Republicans to vote for that bill. So unfortunately the Democrats just are not on board with this.
Now, Diane, is this an all-inclusive bill to prohibit abortion completely, or does it allow for an abortion to be performed in the case of what they call the physical health of the mother being endangered?
Yes, there is that exception, and it is very, very specific about the physical health of the mother being the issue. If there's a physical situation where the mother's life is in danger, then the abortion could be performed. But it specifically says, the bill specifically says that it does not entail any kind of physiological, psychological, or emotional disorder or anything like that. It would not play a role in the decision of the doctor whether to perform an abortion or not. It must specifically be physical.
So, Diane, if a detectable heartbeat is ascertained and a physician were to perform an abortion at that point, he is subject to criminal penalties. Is that correct?
Yes, he is. He'd be subject to a fine and up to 5 years in prison if he did not follow the steps necessary, doing the test to check for the heartbeat, informing the mother, and then performing the abortion. He'd face a fine and up to 5 years in prison.
Wow. Wow.
I'm in favor
of that.
That's
amazing, isn't it, Gary?
It is, and I'm in favor.
Because a baby's heartbeat can be detected about 3 weeks, 1 day after conception. Mm-hmm. So it's definitely a situation where there'd be many babies saved if this bill were to become law. And absolutely, we're hoping, you know, hoping that it would become law.
Well, we're rapidly running out of time, Diane, but where is this bill now in Congress, and what should our listeners do to get it on the move and on the fast track?
Well, it is currently in a subcommittee under the Judiciary Committee, and I don't know why they put it under this one. It just sounds strange. But anyway, they have it under the Subcommittee on Crime, Terrorism, Homeland Security, and Investigations. That is one of the five subcommittees under the House Judiciary Committee. The chairman of that committee is Jim Sensenbrenner, a Republican from Wisconsin, and Louis Gohmert is the vice chair of that that committee. So, you know, I would encourage your listeners to call their House member, their U.S. House member, and ask that individual to support H.R. 490. And it's very important that that be done soon, because it currently is sitting in that committee. It's been sitting in that subcommittee since February 6th.
Okay.
And there seems to be no interest, that, unfortunately, in pushing us. We need to get the phone calls into D.C. to make our voices heard.
Very good.
That'll do it.
Very good. Well, Diane Gramley, thank you very much for being with us today. And ladies and gentlemen, we would encourage you to call your congressman and say, support H.R. 490. And let's get this particular bill on the move.